Linktree is the easy and free way to create a micro page so you can share all of your most important links, whether that's your website, a checkout page, or maybe a link to book a call with you. You can do it all with Linktree. So in this video, I'm going to show you a complete tutorial on how to get started and set up your Linktree page so you can get more clicks and get people to where you want them to go. This video is sponsored by Neo, the new email and growth suite for small businesses that gives you an email address with your own domain name and is full of features that help your business grow. Neo is fantastic because it lets you track when someone opens an email you've sent, schedule appointments with clients and prospects, send marketing mailers, and create a simple website that you can launch in minutes. Try Neo for free today by using the link in the description below. So to get started with Linktree, all we need to do is select sign up for free. And the great thing is that we can get so much out of Linktree without having to upgrade or use their paid service. But we'll go over some of those differences a little later. So I'm going to choose to sign up with my Google account. You can choose to do so, or you can just use an email and password if you like. Now, the very first thing that you're going to need to decide is maybe also one of the most important, and that is choosing a username. This is going to be the end of your Linktree link. This is what others are both going to see and click on, whether you put this in an email, in your social media bio, if you put it really anywhere online, maybe send it via text message. So you want to be careful in selecting a username. Now, of course, it has to be unique. So maybe I want Linktree/simple. That is already taken. Maybe I would like Simple Scott. The good news is that that is available. So that's what I'm going to use for my example. But take your time here and select something that is rather short. The shorter, the better. If you can use your actual business name or the handle that you use somewhere else, all the better. But take your time with this first step. We are going to select continue at this stage. And now Linktree wants to know a little bit about ourselves just so they can personalize the experience. So let's go ahead and we're going to tell them our name. And since I'm using a business example here, I'm going to say that the company name is Simple Solutions. I'm going to select continue, and I'm using it for business purposes. You don't have to make as many selections here. In fact, I'm going to leave everything else down below here as optional and hit continue. We can always change these settings and customize it for our needs later. Now, next up, Linktree is going to ask you which plan you would like to subscribe to. And by default, they are going to select the Pro plan. But when you're just getting started, I recommend that you start with the free plan. In fact, for many of you, the free plan may be all that you need because you can add as many links and linked apps within a free account. Yes, you won't be able to see the analytical data as you would in other paid plans, but for many of you, that may not be necessary. So let's continue with that free option. I'm going to come down here and say join for free. Next up, Linktree is going to ask us how we want to stylize our page. And this is very important so we can match our own branding or give something that looks a little unique. When someone lands on our Linktree page, we want it to look inviting. We also want it to match our logo, for example, or maybe our profile picture, so they know it is one of our links and that they can proceed with clicking on one of the options down below. So they give us a few defaults here, which are really not worth your time. So immediately, I would encourage you to select to add a profile image. I'm going to upload my logo so that it's front and center, that they can see it here when they land on this screen. If you don't have a logo, or if you are using this for personal use, you may want to upload your headshot, preferably something that people are used to seeing in other places. So if you are putting this within your X bio or LinkedIn bio, Instagram bio, for example, when they come here, you want to give them the confidence that they know it's the same person or the same business or organization. Now, down below, we have the choice of choosing a different background theme. And there's a few different combinations here if you like more of a darker background, a lighter background. This one might work well for me because blue is my color, so maybe I'm going to select this one. But don't worry, all of this is editable a little later on. Now, after we are happy with the style that we've selected, we are brought into the Linktree interface. So this is where we have a few different menus here at the top, including links, probably the most important, appearance, where we can go back and change some of the settings that we just set, analytics, which for the most part are only going to be available to those on the paid version. We have limited analytics here within the free account, and some other settings as well. Now, just before we jump to the links, we may want to start with some of our social media icons, because one of the main purposes of using Linktree links is so that you can showcase other options, other pages, other places in which people can connect with you online. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna go ahead and add a few different icons. Maybe, for example, I want to add my Instagram link. So all I need to do in this case is just add my Instagram handle. I don't actually have to go ahead and copy and paste that link. I'm just gonna say add to Linktree. So here I've got that icon, and you can see here on the right-hand side, we have a preview of what it will look like. So if people click on that Instagram icon, they will be taken directly to my Instagram page. Let's go ahead and add one more icon. And in this case, maybe I want to add my email address if I want them to reach out to me directly. So all I need to do here is type in my email address. I'm going to use this fake address in this particular example. And once again, here you can see I have this email icon, which will be displayed here. Now, once we start adding links, we may want to decide if we want these icons near the top of the screen, or if we want to push them down to the bottom. And you have that option here in terms of the position. It doesn't look like it's at the bottom, but what it means is that our links are going to be displayed here in between our Linktree address or our Linktree handle and the icons that we add here. So with that, let's get to the meat and potatoes of Linktree, and is adding our links. Now you'll see that Linktree tries to help us out by giving us a bit of a checklist. The first step here is to add three links. Now, technically, you don't have to add three links, but if you're adding less than three links, Linktree is perhaps not the service meant for you. The whole purpose of Linktree is for you to share a single link, something that is short and clean, again, in a variety of different places, and then give them the ability to access other things, four, five, could be as many as 10 different links on that screen, things that might be more relevant to them. So here, all we need to do is select add a link, and we can really choose anything that we want. Now, the easiest way to do this is to simply copy and paste the URL of any of the pages that you would like to add. So to get started, I'm going to begin with my website. So all I need to do is paste or enter in my website address and select add. And it's going to add that link here on the right-hand side. Now, it's automatically pulled over some information, including the tagline to my website. And in this case, that's not what I want to see. Number one, it doesn't look like it's a website, and it's not really enticing people to go and click on this. No worries, we can change and edit that here on the left-hand side. So instead of having this tagline, maybe I'm gonna put something as simple as website. They're already on my Simple Scott or my Simpletivity Linktree page, so I don't need to say simpletivity.com. I can be a lot more direct and say, this is the website. Or I could say something like, click here to learn more. Whatever I want to say, I can add that here and it will appear within my Linktree page. Now you'll notice that there's a number of different options that we have down below here, including the ability to toggle this on or off. But let's go ahead and add two more links so that we have a few more to play with, and then I'll show you how you can optimize these other options. So I'm gonna add another link here. here, I'm gonna go and copy and paste my YouTube channel in this case, and I'm going to select add. And let's add a third one here. Maybe I want to invite people to subscribe to my newsletter. So you'll see now that we still want to go back in and edit some of these. YouTube.com doesn't sound very enticing, so I'm gonna come here and edit this, and maybe I'm gonna use the proper capitalization and say YouTube channel, so they know exactly what they're getting at. Now with my last entry here to subscribe to the newsletter, you'll see that it pulled in part of an image from that landing page. If I actually go to the landing page, it has tried to pull over this image, but because it's so rectangular, we're only seeing a small portion of it. So again, not very inviting, not very pleasing. But the good news is that we can edit or add additional icons to make these buttons stand out that much more, make them that much more inviting for people to click on. So what I'm gonna do in this case is I'm gonna come up to this subscribe to newsletter, and I'm gonna select the thumbnail option here, and I'm gonna say change. Now we have two choices here. We can either go to our computer and upload our own thumbnail, or we can drag something in from maybe one of our other social media profiles, or we can choose an icon which has already been created here. This is called choose from Tabler icon, so we can choose from a library. So in this case, since it's a newsletter and it's a productivity newsletter, I'm gonna see if they've got something related to a check mark, and they do. I'm gonna go with this circular one here. So now I've got a nice clean circle check mark beside it here. Next down for the YouTube channel, once again, I'm gonna say set that thumbnail, and I could upload my own here if I wanted to. But once again, let's see what they have for YouTube. They do have a YouTube one, so I can continue with that nice clean theme. And lastly, let's do the same here for our website. I'm gonna select change, and let's see, what do they have for something like a website? Well, I guess this is very close to a website. I don't know if it's the most enticing, but at least it is directly associated with where they are going or what they will expect to see. So you can really customize both the labels and the images for each and every one of your links. Now, two other things we want to keep in mind as we continue to add and edit our links here within our Linktree page. Number one, pay attention to how you want to order your links. Here on the left-hand side, we can simply click and drag so we can reorder our links here. Maybe I want them to go to my YouTube channel first and the website is not as important. But you'll also notice here on the right-hand side, we have the option to toggle links on or off. So you might want to go ahead and add a large number of links, everything related to your website, all of your social media platforms, your email address, your lead magnets, your shopping carts, your booking pages, just have it all ready to go. But then you can choose to toggle things on or off. So maybe if I don't want them to come to my YouTube channel, since most of them are finding me there, I can simply toggle it off. It will be removed from my Linktree page, but I haven't lost any of my setup. I haven't lost the URL or the image that I chose. Later on, if I want to enable it, I simply need to come back in here, select that toggle, and now it is back and will appear on my screen. Now, just before I go and start sharing this link with others, I want to pay your attention to something that is almost hidden here, and that is the ability to add a header. So by default, people are going to see your selected profile image, your name. Remember, this is the name of your link. So in my case, it is Simple Scott. And then your links down below, in addition to any other icons that you may choose to add. But sometimes it can be helpful to add a short bio or a short description at the beginning of your Linktree page. And to do that, we want to select add a header. So here we have the option to add a headline tag or title. Now, you are limited to only 35 characters, so you need to be able to make this very, very short. I might say something like, get more done and enjoy less stress. So they know again that it's something similar, it's something that falls in line with the rest of my branding. Or you could change it to something like click below for more info, or get your free resources below. And you could have a link to the different lead magnets or the different free guides that you may offer. So this header section can be very valuable. Even though you're limited to just a few characters, it can tell them just a little bit more about their expectations or what you want them to do next. Now that we've set up our style, we've added some links and added a brief description, you're ready to start sharing this with others. And all I need to do is select copy URL and I can paste it where I like. Now here on the desktop, this is what users will see when they click this link. They have access to the three links in addition to the icons that I have listed down below. Now, of course, Linktree is really maximized for mobile use, because we want to share a lot of valuable information in a relatively small amount of real estate. So this is going to look even better, be that much more helpful for users who click on this on your Instagram profile, on your X bio, on your LinkedIn description, really wherever you include that link. But now they are just one click away from a resource or a page that you want to send them to. So now that you know how to get started with Linktree, I would love to hear from you next. What other questions do you have, and where do you plan to include your Linktree link? Be sure to let me know in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.